What's up, babes? It's your girl Maya Chanel. Welcome back to the channel. If you are here today, you are looking to spice up your content by using Canva, and I'm here to show you guys how to create content or graphics using Canva that are aesthetically pleasing, that are relatable to your audience, and that are more likely to be liked, shared, and saved on your Instagram. And these are different hacks that'll help you grow your audience as well. So I have my screen recorded and I'm going to show you guys today how to create different types of styles of content and make them user-friendly, make them be able to be shared more with your audience and to grow your following on social media. All right, so first things first, we're gonna go ahead and create a design. Let's just go for the Instagram post, okay? So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna create a vibe, honey, okay? So whether you're a clothing brand, you're an entrepreneur, you're a service-based company, these are different things that you can do for your business to spice things up. So first things first you wanna do, what I usually like to start with in the background is like a nice color. So I usually start with a nice color that represents my brand, represents my color palette. Today we're just gonna go with one of the default colors. So let's say we choose like this purple. Okay, so after we choose this purple, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to photos. And if you have images already uploaded, images that you want to use for your company, then go for it. But a lot of people are going for this minimalistic vibe, this aesthetic. And so what I usually type in is minimalistic, either one. I look and I choose a photo that might be very nice in the background. You know, people like the vibes. So let's go with this one. You know, I have the pro feature. So pro is really not that expensive. I think you pay like $12 a month and it's really not. If you're gonna use it all the time, then it's worth it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put this picture right here on top of that color. Then we're gonna go to the transparency and bring it down. Bring it down a little bit, okay? So I can start blending with them colors. I like to bring it down to somewhere like 50%. And then we get that color going in there. Now we got some picture action. We got some of this going. We got some of that going. Boom. So what I like to do now, let's say I want to do like a little message. Like I'm like doing an iPhone message. So what you're going to do here is what I usually like to do, I like to go to the text. And I love using the Be Brave. So I like to use Be Brave text. And then what I do here is I'm gonna highlight all of this so that I can like change the text. So let's say we wanna do shop now. Is there another one under here or something? Like what is going on? Oh, okay, there's two. Okay, I only want one. So let's say I just do shop right here. And then I do hold the Alt key to copy. Now there's other ways that you can like copy, but I just, you know, if it's easy for me to just move my hands right there and do that, then I'm gonna do that. So let me make sure I change this color. So I want this to actually be like, let's say, I want it to be white. So shop now, and then we make sure that we change that color to white. So let's say I just change this and have it going 90 degrees. Okay, come on now. And then I have it, okay, this is kind of off a little bit. Make sure that is aligned perfectly. So shop now. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring one of these over here. And then we're gonna like bring that here. Just kind of like words that represent what you're trying to post. And then just kind of move those all around. So then we're gonna bring this over here again and we're gonna say close or something like that. Or we're gonna say new. We can do new and then just do that. And then kind of like just move these words all around your canvas. So we're gonna do one more here.
We're going to say like dress or something like that. And then let's move that down so that we can have that nicely aligned. What we're going to do here is we're going to take dress. Make sure we get that nice orientation. Put that there. Align it. Let's put a shop down here. But, you know, it's only going to be like those two letters. And then, actually, let's put another shop down here. All right. So now you have this cool little vibe going on. So what I usually like to take over that is like kind of like a little gradient type of vibe. So I go to elements. And this is usually in the, which one is it usually in? So let's say I go to gradient. And then you'll find this right here. So then I usually like to change the color. So let's say I'm choosing the color that I have on here. And then the other one that I'm going to choose is like a white or something, just to like kind of get the vibe kind of going. So actually I want more white. Then if you notice, like, some of them have it like where one is more dominant than the other. Okay, so it just doesn't want to do it how it wanted to do it today. All right, so this is probably actually the one that I want to choose. All right, so this is more of the one that I want to choose. So if you see the difference between these, this is more of like a diagonal type of gradient. This is more of like a linear gradient. So I wanted the diagonal one. So I'm going to put this and align it over the top of this. And I'm going to narrow that down so that it's a gradient over that. And then what I'm going to do next is I'm going to find like a shape. Let's go to the shapes. Now we need to recreate the like the iPhone kind of message vibe thing. So we're gonna use this one where it has like the rounded edges. We're gonna put it in the middle. And then we're gonna make this, let's make it white. Okay, so what we're gonna do there is make this that color. Or what we can do is we can spice it up a little bit, make it this color, and then just turn down that transparency just a tad. Not too much, just a little bit. So then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your text, let's add like a subheading, and then you're gonna add your message. So you can say, "You got this, girl." And then like you can like add your cool little font on there. So let's say I love using Baybuzz New. So, yeah, I'm going to use that for my text. You got this, girl. Let's add, like, a little emoji or something. Let's see. Sparkles! Okay, I did it. Okay, so it doesn't want to add the damn sparkles. Oh, there we go. Okay, so alright, so after that, we're gonna add like the whole like line thing so that we can actually make it look like the notification. So we can say lines, grab this line here, kind of grab that, put it down the middle. We can make it look like a let's make this text white as well. Yeah, I almost misspelled it. You got it, girl. And then we're going to put that right here in the center. Make this white. And then you're going to do like a body text right here. And then you're going to say usually the notification says like dismiss. So you can put that down here in the bottom. Make sure we align this correctly. Make it look right. And then, so you got your little notification here. And then what you want to do, if you want to add like your logo or something for your business here, what you can do is you can go to Elements and you can go to Frames, get a circle, make it smaller, put that on top, like right there. Then you're gonna add like your picture in here. So like, let's say I go to photos and I say logo. Just for example, I can like drop this in there and then boom, it'll have like your picture in there. And then what I'd like to do, I don't know, I've really been in like this little vibe. So you can either leave it just like that, have it very nice for your customers, or you can even add a quote in there if you like and be like, oh, dismiss, like little daily affirmations and stuff that people like. You can even advertise a sale like that and you still have like the shop now and behind it. But I do like to add like this little element right here. I type rip and I go, it's a pro feature now, and I go get this little rip right here. And what I do is I usually like to spread these on like the corners and the edges, and I kind of like catty corner them a little bit, and it gives the post like a little bit of flavor, you know what I mean? So like you can put whatever color that you want to be on here. So let's say I wanted it to be like purple, or like I wanted to go with something like a sort of like a nude vibe on it just to give it a little bit more character. This is what I like to do on my posts to spice things up a little bit, add a little flavor. If I like to do this one, I kind of spread it all the way so that it can be like that. And then boom, you got you a post, girl. So that is some ways to kind of spice up your Instagram content. I know that it's kind of hard sometimes being creative, and it's like you really got to play around with this stuff. Go find other creators. Go find people whose posts that you like. Be inspired by their posts. Don't copy them exactly, but be inspired. Create it in your own way. Make it unique to you. Make it fit so that, you know, it gets your creative juices flowing and gets you in a way that you kind of understand how to create on Canva, how to add different elements, and how to all around be able to create content that your users and potential audience will enjoy. So I hope you guys like this video. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, turn your post notification bells on, share it with someone who this video might be helpful with. And until next time, it's your girl Maya Chanel, and I'm gonna see y'all in the next video.